Hi, this is Gopal Kamath. I am the founder of getyourrestaurant.com, a hotelier and a restaurant owner, and welcome today to one of the most important videos in your life. I am going to teach you today about how to open a QSR. What do you mean by QSR? QSR means a quick service restaurant. Now, with getyourrestaurant.com, we teach people how to open their own restaurants, even if you don't have any experience. As you know, I am a restaurant owner myself. I have multiple restaurants, hotels, and I am the founder of getyourrestaurant.com. So it will be cool to try out this new platform where I am going to screen share with you. As you know, there is a lot of scare about coronavirus, so I am not able to go to my office, to the studio, to shoot videos for you. So I just found out a way to nicely record videos as well as show my face on the screen, so that you get to see me as well as you get to see what I'm going to teach you. I'm sure you must not be that interested in seeing my face as you're interested in knowing more about the restaurant industry. So let's go further and let's check out what I have in store for you. Let's move ahead. So how to open a QSR? First of all, in order to know how to open a QSR, you need to know what is a QSR. So how to open a QSR service restaurant successfully is what we are aiming to get over here. So these are all the brands which you can see which have come up nowadays in the past 5 to 8 years. You can see them in malls, you can see them opposite shopping complexes, in market areas, and all the places where you go, wherever you turn your head, you see one QSR opening with a nice flashy name and a small outlet which is having a counter to with a cashier and people to serve you food. So that is the basic. Let's go to the definition of the QSR. So what is a QSR? So QSR stands for quick service restaurants. So according to sources means internet, a QSR is basically a quick service restaurant, which is a restaurant format which serves customers food which is pre-prepared. So what do you mean by pre-prepared? Is the food actually comes from central kitchen. So there is a central kitchen from where all the outlets are, the food is sent, the pre-prepared food. So pre-prepared food is like gravies and cut vegetables, cut meat or whatever is there. It is all processed in one place and then it is distributed across all the outlets where it is finished and then served to you. So if you see about the pizza chain or the burger chain, whatever the big names you can see, they are all QSR formats. The only thing is they have become big now because they are catering to a lot of people. That's why the size of the restaurant is big, but in itself is still a QSR kind of an outlet because the base food always comes from a central kitchen. So according to sources, QSR is a restaurant format in which customers are served food that is pre-prepared in a base kitchen and assembled in the restaurant kitchen. The service style is mostly self-service and the table turnover is deliberately kept high. What I mean by that is the area where these QSRs tend to be successful are fast moving areas where there are a lot of people moving around, lot of people, there is a lot of floating population to see. So let's see the restaurant feasibility pyramid. This is the restaurant feasibility pyramid which I have made. Actually, this is my creation, and this in one whole chart you get to see all kind of concepts which are coming into this. So this QSR, if you see, it is on the base level of the pyramid. So it mostly targets masses, it targets people who have the food is not that highly priced, the food is moderately priced, the ticket size is pretty low, and the profits are made on masses. So this is where the QSR model resides on the feasibility pyramid. If you want to know more about this restaurant feasibility pyramid, check out the other videos. I have done an exclusive video on restaurant feasibility pyramid, and I have given a link to download the restaurant feasibility pyramid also. So you might go and check in the videos. If you subscribe and if you press the bell icon, then probably you will get a lot of other videos also. If you want, if you like the videos which I am going to move ahead. So let's move ahead. Where are QSRs located? So what are the ideal locations which tend to be more successful for QSR type of restaurant format? First is highly traffic oriented locations like the malls, shopping complexes and commercial complexes. So these are the locations where the volume of people is pretty high and people come to do one or the other thing like shopping, going for a movie, playing games, passing their time. So that is the place where generally QSRs tend to thrive and succeed. The reason is the volume of people is more, it's more of a mass kind of a location, and because it's a mass kind of a location, the ticket size, as I told you earlier, is pretty less. So the relevance of the target clientele as well as the type of restaurant format matches perfectly and it tends to be successful. Another one is opposite railway stations, bus stands. So these are the places where again there are lot of population which is coming in, coming out, going in, going out. So these are the places where the QSR generally thrive. Opposite schools, colleges, universities, lot of hungry population and lot of hungry crowd. So ideally it is said that if you want to be successful, you have to put your product in front of hungry crowd. So irrespective of what your product is, when it is priced right, it will fly off like hot cakes. So schools, colleges, universities is one thing, then near commercial markets or bazaars. So there are places where a lot of people come to purchase things, to buy this, buy that, they are moving around. So, and then they tend to get hungry when the time of the eating food comes. So that is the place where generally people tend to consume a lot of food by going to this area. So this is also one of the best places where commercial markets and bazaars where QSRs can work, and all type of crowded places. So whenever there are crowded places in between a residential area, a naka, where a lot of people come in and they tend to stay and they tend to shop around, these kind of QSRs will work. So what are the requirements for, let's move ahead, this is one of the most important things in this video. What are the requirements for a QSR success? So why do you, what I feel are the things which we should focus on if you want to get your QSR on the success mode. What I mean by success mode is in the profitability mode. No restaurant will be successful if it is not making any profits. If it is not doing losses, I don't think that outlet can be called a success. The first thing is relevant food offering. You have to serve food. Going a little sweaty over here. You have to serve food which is exactly matching the type of people who are coming in. So let's say you have opened a QSR in a market area. You cannot do continental food or Thai food there, because that will be completely mismatched to the type of people who are coming in. Yeah, 5% of the people might come and have the food, but this is one of the biggest mistakes which I think people do. They tend to give food which is totally off the planet and then they expect that it should work. So ideally the type of people who are coming in and the type of food which is served should match like how Lego matches. Second is matching the target clientele to the price point. You cannot serve food which is very, very expensive, or you cannot serve food which is very cheap. If you are serving food which is very expensive, your customer will not be able to afford it. If you are serving food very cheap, you will, as a restaurant owner, you will not be able to afford it, because you will tend to make losses because you will be putting money from your own pockets and ultimately you have to shut down your restaurant. So you have to, the third point is you have to, if you are doing a QSR, you will need to do scale rapidly because you cannot survive on one outlet. Remember, it's a small outlet, it will give you only a reasonable amount of profits. So if you want to increase, you have to expand. Many a times I have seen all their life a person will stick to just one restaurant, however small or medium they may be. They don't have the vision to expand, they don't have the roadmap ahead to expand or the ambition to expand. This is one of the biggest mistake, because what happens is, when you open a restaurant, you already have come into a phase where it is a cycle of business. So it will go up and it will go down, because the area which is there where your restaurant is also evolving. The population is getting saturated and then slowly the people will start moving out and it will start, the area will start get empty. So make sure that you have that vision in mind and start scaling rapidly. Once your initial proof of concept, what I tell is, once your restaurant is fixed, once your restaurant has started making profits, that itself means that your formula is successful. Take that formula, choose the same kind of a location with same kind of people, do some research and open a restaurant in other area which is not competing to your original restaurant. Make sure you expand, because if you don't expand, if you don't grow, then you will die. I'm sorry to say that I'm a little blunt over here. You know how my videos go. The fourth is, you have to be near commercial markets. Many a times people open restaurants which where they try to save on their rent, and they open a restaurant in which is in a such a odd kind of a location where there is no people coming in, no walk-ins or nothing. You don't have to do that. Don't try to be penny wise pound foolish. Even if you lose a little bit more on rent, try to choose a place which is right in the middle of the commercial places. Go to the earlier slide which I have explained, and make sure that you get a location which is beautiful and perfect as far as your selling of the product is concerned. Now the fifth requirement for successful is, you have to cater towards masses. You cannot bring in a product which is highly priced and try to sell it to low income group people, or to poor people, or to the middle class for that matter, because it is not going to work. People will have food. Nobody goes to a market to buy something and have pasta and come back. One or two people might do, but the other 98% will not. So make sure you focus on that, and you have to match your pricing to your existing customers. So the let's go towards the biggest mistakes which I believe the QSR owners do. First is, they totally miss the location part. This is one of the biggest mistakes which I have seen. In fact, out of the 10 flops, 8 of them have got this huge kind of coronavirus in them. Since the coronavirus thing is going on, identifying the wrong location, they try to be smart when finding a location. They try to be smart by saving some rent. They think that, oh my God, the rent is a little high. How will I be able to afford it? Instead of that, you find out a location and you negotiate with the landlord for the rent. Try to tell him to give you some time, at least 6 months or 1 year. You charge me less rent, and after my restaurant start doing well, you go, you give me, you start charging rent from me. Do that instead of choosing a lesser rented place which is totally not in the market, and then it is going to spray water on all your things. Because even if we are saving on the rent part or the deposit part, you have to invest in the decor or whatever. So ultimately, if you miss the location part, you have lost the game from day one. Second is, mismatch of the concept. As I told you in the last slides, people try to sell different things to different people. It's not going to work. People will only have food which they are going to have. They might experiment a little bit here and there, but you cannot sell Italian food to 100% of the Maharashtrian people. Are you trying to get what I'm trying to tell you? You can sell 5% of Maharashtrians Italian food, 10% of Maharashtrians Italian food, but for the remaining 90%, you have to sell them Indian food, Maharashtrian food, Punjabi food. They will not go beyond that. So just example kind of, make sure that you match your concept with the type of people. Underpricing or overpricing the food, biggest mistake at all. I've seen a lot of restaurants close down. Some of the restaurant owners are pretty over smart. They think that, I will sell food cheap and people will go. Nobody is going to come to you because you're selling cheap food. Most of the people are going to think that you are using cheap quality ingredients, and they are not even going to order your food. Please don't take this very rudely, thinking that I am rude. Make sure that you think sensible. Profit should be a number one factor as far as opening a restaurant is concerned. Your profit should be a number one focus. First is the profit, second is the customer satisfaction, third is about the brand. If you don't do profits, there will be no customers, and there will be no brand, there will be no customer service satisfaction. So make sure you keep that in mind. Overpricing is also sometimes a big problem. So what you can do is, you might ask me, what should I do if, how can I come to know whether I am underpricing or overpricing food? Take feedback forms. Give the customers feedbacks. Take feedback from the customers. that ask them what they found about the pricing, whether it is right, whether the quantity is right or no. If you once you start taking feedback from your customers, the customers will literally tell you. The customers will tell you this is wrong, because what happens is once the customers start liking your brand, they want the brand to exist. That's one of the reasons why they give open-hearted feedback. You know, your food is overpriced, your food is underpriced, your food is spicy, your food is oily, your food is salty, whatever. Make sure that you use that feedback, bring it, discuss it with your team, and start changing your menu or start changing your pricing or your food items. That is the only way how your restaurant can evolve. The fourth thing is lack of proper management or cash handling. This is one of the, 50% of the restaurant owners do it. Once the restaurant start doing well, they think that they have got it. Lottery lag gayi. Abhi toh maja karo. Just they enjoy, you know, friends aa rahe hai, khana kha ke ja rahe hai, family aa rahe hai, khana kha ke ja rahe hai. Nobody is charging them anything. This is one of the stupidest mistake which I have seen. People start taking cash, owners start taking cash from their daily cash counter and start spending money. Maja karo, gaadi book karo, mobile le lo. That is not how things work. You have to be like a baniya as far as your money is concerned. You have to save for the rainy day, because all month sales are not equal. I have seen one very, very important project which I myself had did in Maharashtra, which I would not like to name those people. These guys are my friends, but after repeatedly warning them also, they went overboard. They started spending their money. Then their focus on their business was not there, and they had to shut down their restaurant after 2 years. So make sure you don't do that. Irrespective of whether your restaurant is doing well or no, you have to focus on your restaurant. You have to focus on your key performing indicators, your sales, your wastage. In fact, I have done a lot of videos covering these points. So you can always go in the video library on my Get Your Restaurant channel and check out all the videos. So these all things are there. When Hindi, there is a kahawat ke, nazar hati to durghatna ghati. So I think that is one of the important things which you have to focus on. Fifth is lack of continuous promotions of QSR outlets. So nowadays, if you see, there are so many restaurants opening in so many outlets, different types of outlets, different types of food coming in, dessert aa raha hai, Italian aa raha hai, German food aa raha hai, pizza aa raha hai, burger aa raha hai, paratha aa raha hai, Indian people are also coming up with their own varieties, misal pav aa raha hai, chai wala aa raha hai. You have to focus on promoting your brand. Do promote your restaurants via social media, via YouTube, via Facebook, and in fact start distributing flyers also. I know it is a little bit kind of an old thing, but it works. If you distribute flyers every 15 days or 20 days, this will hit your bottom line and it will start increasing your sales, because you will start getting orders. Not the first time, but this third time, fourth time, when people immediately start constantly get the flyers, they start to remember you subconsciously, and then once the time of ordering comes, they will pick up the phone, find the flyer or the menu, and then they will order you. So make sure you promote that. Fifth is lack of focus on customer satisfaction. As I told you again earlier also, once you take the feedback form, you have to make sure that the feedback form issues are being sorted out. A step is taken in order to make sure that that thing doesn't happen again, because your customer is going to wait for one or two times, third time is not going to come. He will give you let's say for example, in my restaurants, I always check. We used to have a feedback that toilets were not clean. So what I did is I took a person and I kept him full time to clean the toilets, and that problem was solved eventually. And that makes the customer came to me and he said, you know, you had issues with your toilets, but then now you're taking care of it. So you make sure that these things are taken care, otherwise the client will not come to you. He will just say tata bye bye, because there are thousands of, irrespective, even if your food is good, you are not having something which they want at the price point which they want. They will obviously tell you tata and they'll go somewhere else. Now let's conclude. So if you liked what I have been teaching you till now, you might check out the new book which I have come up with. It's called as The Restaurant Secrets. Kindly go to getyourrestaurant.com. What is so special about Restaurant Secrets? It is about how to open a restaurant successful even if you don't have any experience. It's a small read actually. It's not a Pulitzer winning novel or something like that. I have just opened my heart out and written what all I want to write about the restaurant industry. It will give you an idea about what to think and what not to think while opening a restaurant. So if you are interested to know more about opening a restaurant or the restaurant business, just check that book out. Go to getyourrestaurant.com. Now, thanks again. This is the last part. I'm concluding my video because I think I've been going on for around 10-15 minutes now. First is, if you like the channel, if you like the videos, do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. Go to that subscribe button, that is the red button, I think so, and there is a small bell icon there, just press it. Share these videos with your friends on Facebook, WhatsApp. Comment on this video, tell me what you feel. I love when somebody likes and comments on the video because it shows me that they are really interested, and if you are asking sensible questions and genuine questions, I tend to reply also. So make sure you do that. This is Gopal Kamath signing off, and I hope to see you on the next video. Thank you so much for watching till now, and see you on the next video. I think the next video which we are going to cover is the nine important steps to create a dream restaurant. I wanted to cover this on the last video, but this QSR thing came into my mind. So make sure you watch the next video. This is Gopal Kamath signing off. Bye bye. Take care. Ta-ta.